Let us take the third question on shear force and bending moment. Here we have a question in which it is given a beam ABCDEF is 12 meter long, is supported as shown in figure, and here we have to draw SFD and BMD, shear force diagram and bending moment diagram for this beam. So we have this question in front of us. Now we would be writing the data for this. As we can look into this question, it is different from the questions we have solved previously. Here we can see an element is there, a section which is 1.5 meter in width and 1.5 meter in height. Over this section we have 40 kilonewton load acting downward and 20 kilonewton load acting horizontally towards left. So now we have to convert this into an equivalent diagram. Now how to convert that? For that I would be taking moment at point C. I'll say that taking moment about point C. Here my convention will be clockwise moment positive and anti-clockwise moment negative. So therefore I will say moment at C is equal to, here I have 40 into 1.5 clockwise minus, because this 20 will produce anti-clockwise moment, so 20 minus 20 into 1.5, and my answer is plus 30 kilonewton meter. Now since my answer is positive, it means at point C there is a moment acting because of this bracket which is given in the diagram, and now that value of moment is 30 kilonewton meter. For that I would be drawing this beam again and showing this value of moment, or you can say couple. So let us start solving this question. We are into question number 3, solution. I will draw this beam once again. So here is the diagram of the beam which is given. I have replaced this bracket with the moment acting at point C, and the answer which I have got, that is 30 kilonewton meter positive, so it is clockwise moment. At the same time there is downward load of 40 kilonewton acting at point C. Now this is the complete beam which we have, and based on this we have to draw the SFD and BMD. So I'll say that there will be reactions at A and reaction at E. So my first step is step number 1, calculation of support reactions. Here I have RA and RC as upward, RA plus RC, 20 into 2, that is the UDL into point load. So here I have minus 40 kilonewton. Again here I have minus 40. Next, 15 into 5, that is 75 in the downward direction, so minus 75 kilonewton. And here I have 30 kilonewton is equal to 0. So therefore RA plus RC will be equal to, here this is my summation of moments, or you can say summation of Fy is equal to 0, upward forces positive and downward forces negative. Here I have minus 80, minus 75, that would be added, so it becomes 155. And in 155, if I add 30, that becomes minus 185. If I shift it onto the other side, so it is plus 185 kilonewton. My equation number 1. After this, I will say that sum of moments of all forces about point A is equal to 0, where I will take clockwise moment positive and anticlockwise moment negative. So I have Re reaction at E into the distance between A and E, that is 10.5. So minus Re into 10.5. Then here I have 15 into 5, that is 75, acting at half of 5, that is 2.5, and it is in the downward direction, so clockwise moment. So here I have plus 15 into 5, that is 75, multiplied by its distance from point A, that will be, here it is 2.5 plus 1.5, that is 4 plus 4, 8. And here I can see one more clockwise moment, 30. So I'll write it as it is because it is positive in the clockwise direction. Next, 40 kilonewton load will also produce clockwise moment. So 40 into 4. Then I have 20 into 2 acting at half, that is 1. So plus 20 into 2. So from this, I am getting reaction at E. It comes out to be 113.33 kilonewton. After we put 113.33 kilonewton in equation number 1, I will get Ra as 71.67 kilonewton. So here I complete my step 1, where I have calculated the support reactions. I can write the values here. After completion of step 1, we will go on to step number 2, that is shear force calculations. In shear force calculations, first I will draw the sign convention. Upward force to the left, downward force to the right, both are positive. Downward force to left and upward force to right, both are negative. So I will start SF calculation with point A. So SF at point A will be equal to, here my assumption is that the section is just to the right of A. It is here. So now, if I am taking this section, to the left of that, I have only one force and it is upward, so positive. So that is 71.67 kilonewton. Then after this, I will be calculating shear force at point B. And that value is, my section is at point B. So here I have 71.67 as upward, 20 into 2, that is 40 into downward direction. So here I have 71.61 minus 40, that will give me 31.67 kilonewton, positive sign.